Hi there, this is Valentine, and in this video, we're going to take a look at more advanced schema validations. If you remember, in the previous video, we have defined a very simple schema for a very simple response. If you missed that video, check the notification icon and make sure you watch that first before continuing with this one. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to do more advanced things, and we're going to look at nested objects, and we're going to look at arrays. They are all often part of the response body, and it's important to know how to deal with them as well. But first, I wanted to show you how you can limit the number of properties that you get from this response. So for example, if in this case, I'm still getting only an additional property. So for example, if I add here arrow as well to the response, and let's say this is an empty object, you will see that the error is now in the response, but the results are still valid. Now, if you want to avoid having properties that you don't know about, or you want to be sort of informed every time something changes, really changes in the response, then you can add an additional configuration to the schema. And this is called additional properties. And if I specify additional properties false, then what this will do is it will not allow additional properties. So now the schema validation should fail because it will say here, data should not have additional properties, but found errors. So for that reason, this is something that will not be included. Now let's assume that we have a nested object called error, and the error itself has a property called message. So what we need to do next is to go to properties. I'm going to define the property error, and the type will be object. And additionally, we have the possibility of defining properties in a similar way to how we have started a level previously. So now we'll say properties, and the only property that exists here is message. And we're going to make the property message required. And additionally, a level above this, we're going to make error required. So now the test results are valid, and let's now try to break them. So for example, if we say errors, it should fail. If we change it back to error, but we don't include a message, this should fail as well, because the property that was required message does not exist. I'm going to include it back. Now let's assume that the message is a number, not a string. And it says now data error message should be string. So now it seems that we have everything that we need in order to know how to work with nested objects as well. And again, if on this level there would be another nested object, the same principle would apply. We'll have type object, we'll have properties. Of course, you can add additional properties here as well. So these additional properties will only work in one level. So you need to replicate this on each level that you have. Finally, oftentimes we get arrays as well. And it's important to know how to deal with arrays, because even if technically arrays are objects, when it comes to schema validation, we need to treat them differently. So if this response will include now, for example, a property called tags, and we'll add some tags here as an array, the way we define the property here is that we say tags as a property. The type will be array, and it should be enough for the initial validation. So you now see tags is an array. Now if we try to make this an object, data tags should be an array. So let's revert it back to an array. What we can do is to define additional conditions that this array should fulfill. For example, we always want to have at least one item, so for that we can use min items. But just as well, we can add max items and say we don't want more than 3 items. So if for whatever reason we don't include any items in the array, we just provide an empty array, the schema will fail because the array doesn't include one item. And if we add 4 items, for example, this again will not satisfy the schema. Small typo here. This will not satisfy the schema because now it has more than 3 items. You'll notice how easy it is to make a misspelling, and if you don't test for it, the test will not fail. So it's definitely something you need to keep in mind. I'm going to leave it with 2 elements here. Additionally, in this case, you will see I only have strings. And most of the time, you will see that you only get one certain type. And you can even test for that specific type. For example, if I specify items, now I have the possibility again of defining the type. So if I say here number, this will fail because they are not numbers. Data tags should be number. They are actually strings. And now the schema is valid. So in this tutorial, you have learned how to deal with additional properties and if you should allow or not allow additional properties. And you need to keep in mind that this is different from required, because additional properties only goes on the properties that are defined here. So for example, tags is optional because it's not in the required list, but additionally, it will not trigger any failures if it exists or doesn't exist. But if we introduce something new, like more tags or something like that, that will fail because it is not defined in the schema. So it means we don't know about it. Additionally, we learned how to deal with nested objects, and you'll see that what happened on one level is simply replicated on other levels as well. So type object, properties, properties, what's required, and so on. So that's pretty, pretty easy. If you understand to do one level, you can go with nested objects without any issues. And finally, arrays. Tags is an array. I said here the type is array, and you can do a lot of configurations. For example, setting minimum items, maximum items. What kind of type should the items have? Now, there are additional more configurations that you can do, so I only presented some configuration options, but you can go into much more details. For that reason, in the video description, you will have the Postman Quick Reference Guide, and it includes a lot of examples on how you can build different schemas. And generally, if you have any questions regarding how to build your own schema, just send me a comment in the section below. Let me know what you're working on, what's the problem that you're facing, and I'll do my best to give you examples and point you in the right direction. Also, check the video description because I will point you to some JSON schema documentation where you can look up other configurations that you can do on your own. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was useful. If this was the case, as always, please, please subscribe to this channel. It really helps me create more videos and provide you this on a weekly basis, at least to provide you more tutorials and training in this direction. Give this video a thumbs up and see you next time at another tutorial. Bye bye.